Good morning to all the faculties and delegates. Myself, Dr. Komal. I am a third year PG resident in Department of Radio Diagnosis from Maharishi Markandeshwar University, Mulana. My topic of today's presentation is fetal echocardiography for early detection of congenital heart diseases. Fetal echocardiography represents one of the most exciting and rapidly evolving areas in the field of pediatric cardiology. The increasing advances in prenatal diagnosis, ability to intervene medically, percutaneously, and perhaps surgically on the fetus has enhanced the importance of prenatal detection of congenital heart disease. Fetal echo is completely non-invasive, it is harmless, and is the best tool in this direction. In this paper, we present analysis of fetal echo cases which were referred to the tertiary cardiac center. So total number of cases that we have taken are 478, and the study was performed for about 5.5 years duration. The patients were taken from the local city, having a population of around 1.5 million, with a birth rate of 14.2, and expected birth of congenital heart disease babies is being 6 to 8 per 1,000 live births. Detail regarding the gestational age, maternal and family history, exposure to teratogens, and reason for referral were recorded. Through a curvilinear probe, we made the standard views, and the views were four-chamber view, outflow tract views, three-vessel view, aortic and ductal arch views. The average gestational age at the referral was 24 plus minus 4 weeks, and the maternal age was 24 years. The referral were of abnormal fetal cardiac scan, previous siblings suffering from the congenital heart disease, maternal indications like congenital and the rheumatic heart disease, mothers suffering with diabetes mellitus, with SLE, tuberous sclerosis, having the history of drug ingestion. Then others were echogenic intracardiac focus, then other extracardiac malformations. So the patients who were referred for abnormal fetal cardiac scan, out of them, 68% were of abnormal four-chamber view, 17% for cardiomegaly, 8.6% for abnormal outflow tract view, 2.3% for abnormal axis, and other were 3.1%. So 128 patients were there with abnormal scan, 99 patients with previous siblings with congenital heart disease, 87 with maternal indications, 87 with echogenic intracardiac focus, 50 with high risk, and 21 with arrhythmias. So out of that, 268 patients were found normal, 86 were found to have congenital heart disease, 103 patients with echogenic intracardiac focus, 17 patients with arrhythmias, and the females, there were about 66% of the females with gestational age more than 22 weeks, 14% with gestational age less than 20 weeks, and around 17% with gestational age more than or around 18 to 20 weeks. So various type of congenital heart diseases that were diagnosed were ventricular septal defect, hypoplastic left heart syndrome, hypoplastic right heart syndrome, atrioventricular septal defect, right atrium and right ventricle dilated, tricuspid atresia, tetralogy of Fallot, single atrium, single ventricle, truncus arteriosus, tetralogy of Fallot with absent pulmonary valve, and double outlet right ventricle, tetralogy of Fallot with pulmonary atresia, coarctation of aorta, severe tricuspid regurgitation, Epstein with severe tricuspid regurgitation, dextrocardia, and CTGV, that is congenitally corrected transposition of great vessels. So here is the image showing a female with 26 weeks old fetus. And here we see ventricular septal defect and overriding of aorta. This is the aorta and this is the ventricular septal defect. And on color comparison, we see the aorta is having connection with both the ventricles. Then another female with 30 weeks of gestation showing a hypoplastic left ventricle, another patient with hypoplastic right ventricle. Then 26 week of gestation, a female. Here there is absent pulmonary wells, and on color Doppler, we see pulmonary regurgitation and stenosis. Then in A figure, four chamber view with gestational age of 24 weeks, showing single atrium with multiple ventricular septal defect. This is a single atrium, and here are multiple ventricular defects. Then in image B, four chamber view in 24 weeks old fetus, and here the arrow is showing a atritic tricuspid valve, which is suggestive of tricuspid atresia. Then again, a four chamber view in a patient with high drops, showing hugely dilated right atrium with severe tricuspid regurgitation. Then another patient with 25 weeks of gestation with Epstein anomaly with the severe tricuspid regurgitation. So the main reason for referral for fetal echo in our study was abnormal cardiac scan, and which was found in 128 patients. The high incidence of echogenic intracardiac focus, which was found in our study, was because of the parental anxiety, because the parents wants to have a second opinion. And the cases which were having a previous history of siblings suffering from the congenital heart disease was 99, which was probably due to our center performing pediatric cardiac surgeries. The optimal time for the performance of comprehensive transabdominal fetal echo was around 18 to 22 weeks. In India, the upper limit of medico-legal termination of pregnancy is at 20 weeks. On correlation of our result with referral indication, the highest yield of congenital heart disease was in patient with abnormal fetal cardiac scan. In the cases with arrhythmia, one case had an association with SLE, otherwise there was no congenital heart diseases found. In our study, no CHD was detected in patients who were referred for various maternal indications like diabetes, hypothyroidism, hypertension. One patient with tuberous sclerosis had rhabdomyomas. In five patients with drug injection, three had complex congenital heart diseases. The low association of CHD with fetal arrhythmias and maternal diabetes and fetal echogenic intracardiac focus is seen in our study is similar to be noted in some previous reports. And also the very low prevalence of extracardiac anomalies in our study population is likely to be due to underreporting. So the limitation in our study are that the information regarding the precise actual diagnosis was incomplete, as many patients who opted for pregnancy termination refused autopsy and only a few came for follow-up. And also the operator was aware of all the referral indications. So the conclusion is, early fetal echo can effectively identify abnormal heart, and prenatal therapy has enhanced the survival. The main concern in the Indian scenario is late referral. Late referrals to dedicated center, especially in high-risk patient, will hopefully facilitate a better outcome for the neonate with CHD. However, echocardiography screening after birth may not be too late for management. Thank you.